Okay, dear students, we are in determinants miscellaneous exercise. We have given 4.7 for this exercise number, and we want to finish this exercise today. Why? Because up to 13, I think question number 13 we have finished in the last class. From question number 14 onwards, we will try to solve now. 14, 15, 16 are subjective questions. 17, 18, 19 are objective questions, multiple choice. Okay, let us do the 14th question. You see 14, 15, 16, I think 14, 15, up to 15, all we have to prove. LHS is equal to RHS, like determinant, they have given something, some value or equation or expression, whatever it may be. Okay. You see now, how to prove this one or any direction? If you don't find any direction, simple thing is you have to make 1, 1, 1 and make 2 zeros. Then 1 will be there, 1 1 will be there. Then reduce the expression. Then you may get this. See, trial and error, that's all. Okay, how to get is the 1 1 1 one side. You see, here possibility is there. 1 2 3, 1 will be like this only. 2 you have to make 0. 3 you have to make 0. How to make 2 0? 2 minus 2 are 1. 2 into 1. 2 minus 2 into 1. Then it is going to become 0. In matrices we have done this, while elimination method, all these we have to utilize those experiences. Okay, here also 3 minus 3 into 1, 0. Both zeros are going to become, accordingly these values are also going to change. Then we will do, whether we will see whether this one comes or not, like, okay, this is the procedure we have to follow, like that. Why? Because here we don't have any hint or what we can say, idea to proceed except this. Okay, let us do what I am writing. You simply observe R2 minus 2R1. Okay, R2 is changing, R2 minus 2R1, and R3 also changing, R3 minus 3R1. Okay, R2 and R3 changing, R1 is not changing. Okay, slowly one by one we will do. Why? Because calculations also we have to do. Okay, let us do that is equal to, okay, first of all you write down R1, 1 plus P, 1 plus P plus Q. Why? Because there is no change in R1. Okay, see R2, see 2 minus 2 into 1, 0. Okay, this is okay, but what about this? You write down now. 3 plus 2P minus 2 into R1. 2 into 1, 2. 2 into P plus 2P. Okay, see. 3 minus 2 is 1. 2P minus 2P is 0. Then you only 1. Understand now? Slowly those are getting reduced. Here also you see 3P plus 2Q minus, okay, this is R2 minus 2R1. 2 into 1, 2. 2 into P, 2P. 2 into Q, 2Q. Okay. 4 minus 2, 2. 3P minus P plus P. 2 plus P. 2Q minus 2Q, 0. 2 plus P. That's all. 2 plus P, you write. Okay. This is the case of R2. Then let us do for R3 also. R3 what we have to do? R3 minus 3R1. 3 minus 3. 0. Okay, now you write down this. 6 plus 3P. R3 minus 3 into R1. R1 is what? 3 into 1, 3. Plus 3 into P, 3P. Plus 3 into Q, 3Q. Okay? This 3 again we have not write. Why? Because already we have multiplied 3 into R3 minus 3 into 1, 3 into P, 3 into Q. Okay, now you see. Where we are doing? We have to do here. We have done mistake. Okay, you see. R3 minus 3R1. R3 is 6 plus 3P. Okay, 3R1 means this one we have to do. 3 plus 3P. Is it okay? 3 into 1, 3 into P. Okay, 6 minus 3, 3. 3P minus 3P, 0. Then you have to write only 3. That's all.
Okay. Now let us go. R3 minus 3 R1. R3 10 plus 6P plus 3Q minus 3 R1. 3 into 1 3 plus 3P plus 3Q. 3P, 3Q. Okay. 10 minus 3, 7. 6P minus 3P plus 3P. Plus 6 minus 3 plus 3. 3Q, 3Q going to get cancelled. 7 plus 3P, all right. 7 plus 3P, that's all. Okay. Now you will get your answer. Okay. Now you see two zeros are there, one is there. How to expand? 1 into AD minus BC. AD is 1 into something means same. 7 plus 3P. Or see any one this thing is there, you need not keep this. Okay, minus AD minus BC. BC, you see what I am doing, I am multiplying this. 3 into 2, 6. 3 into P, 3P. Is it okay? AD minus BC. Minus BC means this minus apply to all this. B and C. Okay, now 1 into something you need not write again. But if you open the bracket, you see 7 minus 6, 1. 3P minus 3P, 0. That's all 1. Direct 1. Okay. Hence proved. Like that you write and close this question. Let us go for 15th question. Okay. See the 15th question. Question number 15. Prove. See sin alpha, cos alpha, cos alpha plus delta is there. Alpha, beta, gamma. Alpha, beta, gamma. Alpha plus delta. Beta plus delta. Gamma plus delta. Sin, sin, sin. Cos, cos, cos. Cos, cos, cos. See one sequence it has been followed. We have to prove this equal to 0. Okay? See, unless you expand this, you won't get any idea what I feel. Why? Because directly you cannot do. Why? Because here sin, here cos. Okay? You expand this first term. Then you get idea and think whether that is applicable for all or not. Like that you have to proceed. Okay. See how I am doing. I am expanding that. Cos alpha plus, you see. Cos of alpha plus delta. I am expanding. Okay. See cos A plus B. Cos of A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Okay. Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. A B. A B. A B. Okay. You see, by seeing this, you get an idea. You have to get some idea. See, cos alpha is there. Sin alpha is there. You see, there. Cos alpha is there, sin alpha is there. But you have to multiply sin alpha, sin delta here, sorry, here, cos delta here. You have to multiply. If you multiply all, you have to multiply column wise. Okay, here also same thing will come. You see, this formula applicable for here also, na? Here you have to multiply with sin delta, cos delta, sin delta. Okay, afterwards what you have to do? See, you have to make it is 0. Okay. See, how can be made 0, one determinant? Two conditions are there. First condition, you have to make elements of any column equal to another column. C1 is equal to C2, C1 is equal to C3, or C2 is equal to C3, all. Then that is going to become 0. That is one thing. Or else, you have to make all zeros. Okay, any one row or column. C1 is equal to C2 or R1 is equal to R3 or R2 is equal to R3 also you can make. Then also it is going to become 0. But here what we are going to make, you see, we will multiply C2 with cos delta, C1 with sin delta. Afterwards what we are going to do, we are going to do C2 minus C1. Okay, C2 after multiplication it is going to become cos alpha cos delta, minus after multiplication it is going to become sin alpha sin delta. That means C2 minus C1, if you make, automatically this formula will come, and you write in any one column, C2 minus C1, write in C2, changing in C2, C2 minus C1, you write in C1, okay, C2. Then C2 and C3 is going to become equal. Why? Because see, you have expanded, you have not expanded, same values are there. Or else another step you take and write this as cos alpha plus delta, cos gamma plus delta, like you write, or else you don't require to write. Then finally you have to write C2 is equal to C3, that is equal to 0. Like that you can write and close this question. You understand now? Huh? Until you expand this, you don't get this idea. Okay, let us proceed. How I am proceeding, you see. I am writing like this. C1 is changing. Okay, what is the change? C1? C1 is this one. Huh? Sin alpha into sin delta. Okay, C1 sin delta, and C2 is changing. Okay, what is the change? C2 cos delta. Okay, C1 sin delta you have to multiply, C2 cos delta you have to multiply. Okay, let us multiply and write first. In the next step we will do subtraction, this formula like it will come. Okay, let us do that. Is equal to, okay, C1 all with sin delta have to multiply, sin alpha sin delta, sin beta sin delta, sin gamma sin delta. Okay, okay, now here also cos delta, cos alpha cos delta, cos beta cos delta, cos gamma cos delta. Okay, and here you have to write cos of alpha plus delta, cos of beta plus delta, cos of gamma plus delta. Is it okay? Okay, one more step we write. In the next step, C2 is changing, C2 minus C1. Okay, that we will write here. Then that will be final. Okay, see how I am writing. Okay, C2 is changing. What is that change? C2 minus C1. C1 we are not changing, C1 same, C2 only with changing, C2 minus C1 and writing in C2. Okay, write down, that is equal to, okay, C1 no change, sin alpha sin delta, sin beta sin delta, sin gamma sin delta. Okay, here C2 minus C1, C2 is this one, cos alpha cos delta minus C1 sin alpha sin delta, sin alpha sin delta, we can write anyway, cos beta cos delta minus sin beta sin delta, cos gamma cos delta minus sin gamma sin delta. C3 same you have to write. Cos alpha plus delta, cos beta plus delta, cos gamma plus delta. Okay. Now over. Now see, you need not write this again, cos alpha plus delta, like cos alpha plus delta, like directly we can write here. How can you write next step? You see, that is equal to 0 because C2 is equal to C3. When C2 is equal to C3, all elements,
then you can write 0. Okay, this is a property of determinant. Okay, elements. See, now this is, if you expand this, this also become like this, or if you contract this cos alpha plus delta, it is going to become, then both are same, that is why we are writing 0 like. Okay, a little bit carefully I have read beta delta gamma delta alpha delta. You should be very careful about writing this. Okay, what we do, we go for 16th question. Okay, let us go see 16th question. What they have given? Solve the system equations. We know very well how to solve this system equations. System consistency, we have to see elements, we have to take and write A matrix, then x, y, z will be there in x, and B is 4, 1, 2, we know very well. But here one complexity is there. You see, here x is not there, 1 by x is there. You see, 2x is not there, 2 by x is there, 3 by y, 10 by z, all like that only. Then how to write this? Okay, see how I am writing. Observe carefully. Okay, see, let A is equal to 2, 3, 10, 4, minus 6, 5. Okay, because minus is there. Okay, 6, 9, minus 20. How I am writing X, you observe carefully. X is not X here, X, Y, Z. Here X is 1 by X, 1 by Y, 1 by Z. Is it okay? You see, X is 1 by X, 2 by X, 3 by Y, 10 by Z, 4 by X, 4 by Y. See, if you multiply this, same is going to come like this equation. Okay? Such type of questions 1 or 2 you have to do. Suddenly if you find this question in your examination, then you are unable to do it. Okay, now you can get this idea how to write and all. Here only x, y, z only you are changing, remaining all same, b also same. 4 1 2. Okay, now how to solve this? X is equal to A inverse into B. A inverse and B are both same, but final answer, rather than X, 1 by X is equal to that answer, 1 by Y is equal to that answer, 1 by Z is equal to that answer, you have to solve. Then Z or Y or X will come automatically. Okay? Okay. Let us do. See, first what we have to do? Consistency we have to see. Determinant we will do here. But because until now question has come here, now I will do determinant here, then we will make one line afterwards. Okay, let us do the determinant. Determinant A is equal to, see, this is going to come bigger. See, such type of question we have got now, 1200 something it is going to come determinant. You see, plus 2 into, okay, you see, 1200, 6 into 12, sorry, 120, not 1200. 120 plus 120 minus 45. Is it okay? Okay. Minus 3 into, why I am doing, see, minus are going to utilize. Minus and cofactors, A inverse you have to find. Nah? Unless you find A inverse, you cannot find X. That is why standard procedure only I am doing. Okay, minus 3 into, okay, see, minus 18, minus 30. Okay, minus 18, minus 30, plus 10 into 36 minus of minus 36, plus 36, 36 plus 36. Is it okay? 36 plus 36, both are positive.
Okay.
Okay, now let us write down this determinant. Determinant, calculate the determinant. Determinant A is equal to 120 minus 45. You see, 120 minus 50 is 70. But 45 means 5 more. 75. 75 into 20. 75 into 2. 150. Okay.
See, minus minus is there, plus will come. 80, 30, 110. 110 into 3, 11 threes are 33, 330. Here also plus C only will come. 36, 36, 72, 72 into 10, 720.
Okay.
Okay, 30 plus 20, 50, 750 plus 300.
1050, 1050, 50, 1100, 1100 plus 100, 1200.
Okay, One more you write, determinant A is not equal to 0 consistent. Why? Because here system they have written. Whenever system is there, some system consistency on solution available, write that if you want, you can write. Okay, let us proceed further.
I think afterwards we can go top also. Why? Because this determinant also, once you write, you don't require. 1200 is determinant, you keep in your mind. Why? Because we will rub up to here next time. Question we don't rub, or else this question also we can rub up to here if you don't have space. Okay, see, now what is the procedure? See, procedure is like earlier only. Minors you have to find, cofactors you have to write, adjoint you have to write, determinant already there, A inverse you can find, 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. X is equal to A inverse into B, B already you are having. A inverse into B if you do, then X will come. That X is 1 by X, 1 by Y, 1 by Z. Then you change in X, okay? Like that we will do. Okay, let us do it. Minors I am writing M11 and all. You see how I am writing. M11 is equal to 75. This already we have calculated. M12 is equal to minus 110. M13 is equal to 72. Okay? These three minors already we have calculated. Let us do remaining minors. M21. You see, 4 you are closing. Minus 60, minus 90. Minus 150. Minus 60. Minus 90, yes, minus 150, 60, 90. M22, minus 6 you are closing, minus 40, minus 60, minus 100, minus 40, minus 60, minus 100. M23, 5 you are closing, 5 if you close, 18, minus 18, 0. 18, minus 18, 0. Okay, at least 1 0 has come. Zeros are going to save us time, our time. M31. 6 we are closing. 15 plus 60, 75. M32. 9 we are closing. 9 if you close, you see 10 minus 40, minus 30. Once again we will see. 10 minus 40. 10 minus 40, minus 30. Yes, okay. M33. Minus 20 if you close, minus 12, minus 12, minus 24, minus 12, minus 12, minus 24. Okay. Now you see, all 9 minors you have got. You have to write cofactors now, cofactors. Let us write cofactors. We know very well how to change the sign. Only you have to change the sign of this minors, cofactors means. Not for all, we will change alternately. First, we don't change any sign. Then you change the sign, don't change sign, change the sign, don't change sign, change the sign. Don't change the sign. Change the sign. Don't change the sign. Okay. Now you have got cofactors. After cofactors, adjoint you have to write. Let us write adjoint. Adjoint A is equal. First write the formula. Adjoint A is equal to. No, this is not the formula. Adjoint directly you can write. There is no formula. Adjoint.
Okay, 75, 110, 72, vertical you have to write. Write down. 75, 110, 72. Okay? 150, minus 100, 0. 150, minus 100, 0. Okay? 75, 30, minus 24. 75, 30, minus 24. Okay. Now you see, this is adjoint only. But you have to find A inverse. A inverse also again you have to find. Write first formula of A inverse. A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. Okay. Write that. You see, A inverse is equal to 1 by 1200 into 1 by 1200 into this adjoint you write, copy. 75, 110, 72. 150, minus 100, 0. 75, 30, minus 24. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, now we have to rub, but determinant also we know, okay? Now just x is equal to A inverse into B, we have to write and we will do here. I don't think here also enough, again we have to go that side. Let us finish, determinant A we know very well, okay? Up to determinant I am going to remove here, we will take this space, okay? Okay, note down and I am going to remove this. Okay, see, what to be done? A inverse you got, B also you are having. You write this formula first. X is equal to A inverse B. Okay? If that is the formula, then write down. X is equal to A inverse. 1 by 1200 you keep outside like that only as a scalar. And again you write 75, 110, 72. 150, minus 100, 0, 75, 30, minus 24, okay? This is A inverse, but what about B? B is 4, 1, 2, okay? Okay, let us do calculation here only, then afterwards again we will rub this side and we will go that side. Why? Because we have to solve the system means final answer will come. This and all you don't require afterwards. Okay. Now once again you write x is equal to 1 by 1200 into. You see only 3 numbers will come here. Calculation. 75 into 4, 300. Plus 150. Plus 150. Okay. 75 into 2, 150, into 4, 300, okay, 440, minus 100, plus 60, okay, 4 2s are 8, 4 7s are 28, 288, 0, 0 you don't write, but minus 48 you write. Okay, see, here x or final values are going to come. We don't require this also. I am going to rub this also. Note down, pass and note down. Why? Because this is a big question like. Okay, see, now we will add x is equal to 1 by 1200 into 600 plus, sorry, 600 only, 150, 150, 300 plus 300, 600, 600 See, 440 plus 60, 500. 500 minus 100, 400. Here I think 8 minus 8, 0. 8 minus 4, 4. 240. Okay. Now you send inside 120, 1200. If we send inside, what will happen? 600 by 1200, 1 by 2. 400 by 300, 1 by 3. 240 by 1200. 12 twos, 12 ones, 10. 2 ones, 2 fives, 1 by 5. Okay. Now you see, x is equal to 1 by 2, capital X. 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 5. That means small x is, see, 1 by x is equal to, here 1 by x is there, that carefully you have read. 1 by x is equal to 1 by 2, x is equal to 2. Okay? 1 by x is equal to 1 by 2, x is equal to 2. 1 by y is equal to 1 by 3, x is equal to, sorry, y is equal to 3. 1 by z is equal to 1 by 5, comma, z is equal to 5. Okay. Like this you have to write and close this question. Okay. Let us go for 17th question. 17, 18, 19 are objective questions, but those also will take time like this. Even though those are objective multiple choice. Okay. See this question. 17th question is objective or multiple choice question. Four answers they have given. You have to find any one correct line. A, B, C are in arithmetic progression. Where these A, B, C's are there? See here. 2A, 2B, 2C. Okay. Arithmetic progression or arithmetic series. Series also you have to call. Okay. You have to know the word series also. Why? Because rather than India and US, UK and all, they are going to call as series. Arithmetic series. Geometric series like. Okay. Arithmetic progression. Then delta is. This delta value is what like they are asking. Okay. How to find this? See, some logic they only given. A, B, C are in arithmetic progression means first we have to see what is this A, B, C. In arithmetic progression in class 11 we have studied. Of course, I have not told. But in our class 11, this is class 12 means class 11 you must have studied. Okay. You see how to write this arithmetic progression. A will be there, B will be there, C will be there. But A plus D, if you add, that is equal to B. C, B plus D, if we add, that is equal to C. That means A is equal to 2D plus C. Sorry. C is equal to 2D plus A. Okay. C is equal to 2D plus A plus 2D. A plus D is B. A plus 2D is C. A plus 3D is D. Like that goes on, it goes. Okay. We know very well that B is equal to A plus C by 2. By this only it will come. Okay. B is equal to center 1. A plus C by 2. That means 2B is equal to A plus C. I have sent 2B this side. Okay. Now what I am going to do? I will multiply with 2 both sides. That means 2 into 2, 4B is equal to 2A plus 2C. Is it okay? 2 into 2, 2, 4B, 2A, 2C. Okay, this is very important, crucial for your calculation. Why? Because you see here, 2A is there, 2C is there. 2A is there, 2C is there. If you make this 4B, how to make into 2 if you multiply? Automatically, these are going to get cancelled. If all are going to get cancelled, if 0 comes, then 0 is going to become. Or else we will see whether any value comes or not. Why? Because see, our aim is to reduce, to make 1, 1, afterwards 0, 0. Here one chance we are getting to make 1, 0. But here 0 or 1 are going to come means we will reduce the equation, determinant. Let us see. If rather than 1, all 0 comes means automatically 0. Okay? Like that we have to think. This formula you have to keep in our mind. This formula nothing but this only. B is equal to A plus C by 2 already you have studied in your this thing. How it has come and all I have explained to you. Okay. Let us proceed. Okay. What I am writing, you see, we are this is object question. We don't do more rough work. But we will simply come to the point. Okay. What I am doing, you see, this is R2. R2 I am multiplying with 2R2. Or else I am writing like this. R2 is changing. Okay, what is the change? 2R2. 2 into R2. Why? Because 4B I want to make this. Minus R1 plus R3 together. R1 plus R3.
Okay.
If you multiply, see what is happening here. I am writing, you see. R2 is changing. Okay, that is okay. But 2R2 means 2 into X. Okay. 2 into 2B. 4B. 2X, 4B, it will become. R2 R2 minus R1 plus R2 X plus X 2X plus 2A plus 2C 2A plus 2C. Okay, see 2X 2X are going to get cancelled. Minus 4B is equal to 2A plus 2C. You see 4B is equal to 2A plus 2C. This is also going to get cancelled. That means here 0 will come.
Okay,
Here 0 will come. For that sake only we have done all these things. Now come to the here C2. C2 also you see 2 into X 2X plus 2 into 4 8.
Okay.
Now you add this 2X 5 plus 3 8. This also going to become 0 here.
Okay.
Okay. Now come here. 2 into X 2X plus 2 into 3 6. Why? Because we are doing all R2. All R2 we are doing with the multiplication with 2. Then all R1, R3 we are adding and subtracting. Okay, this has come 2x plus 6. Now you see 2x plus x, 2x plus 4 plus 2, 6. This is also going to become 0 when you minus subtract. Okay, now you tell me, if any one row or column, all 0 comes means what will be the determinant value? Determinant value is 0.
You understand now?
Like this you have to do this question, solve this question. Okay.
Let us go for 8. Okay. See the 18th question. This is a conceptual based question, but we have to do this calculation and all.
If x, y, z are non-zero real numbers, that means x, y, z are non-zero. Those are not zeros. Then the inverse of matrix A, we have to find this inverse. See, all are zeros. But minus cofactors, easily it will come. Determinants you have to find, cofactors you have to, minors you have to find, cofactor you have to find, adjoint you have to find, then find A inverse. A, B, C, D they have given, I am not writing that much big. We will do, let us do directly and final answer we are going to get this. This is objective type question only they have given. Even if they can give this as a subjective question also. Okay. How to proceed and now let us see. First of all what you have to do, determinant you have to find. Let us find determinant A is equal to. You see x into yz. Okay. X into yz. Why? Because 0 is there. Yz minus 0, 0. Afterwards 0, 0. That's all. That means x, y, z will be your determinant. Okay. You can write determinant A is not equal to 0. Why? Because x, y, z are non-zero layout hold. That is why consistent. Consistent A inverse exists. Exists.
Okay. Now, minus. Minus you have to find.
Observe carefully how we are doing minus. M11 is equal to, you see, x if you close, yz minus 0 means yz. If you close M12 means, you see, 0 if you close, 0, 0, 0. M13, 0. Okay? M21 0 M22 XZ will come. M22 carefully observe. XZ minus 0 that means XZ. M23 0. Okay. Observe carefully how we are doing. M31 0 M32 0 M33 XY minus 0 that means XY. Observe carefully. All are not going to come 0. Some values are there. M11, M1, M22, M33 have come. That means diagonal. Diagonal have come. Okay.
Okay.
Now cofactors also have to write. Cofactors you change the sign and all. See, I think you see plus minus plus minus plus minus plus minus plus. That means plus will come. See, cofactors directly you can write. Remaining all zero means you can write this like cofactors directly. See, remaining all zero. A11 I am writing. You see, A11 is equal to YZ. A22 is equal to this one XZ. A33 XY. Okay? Why? Because these are all plus only here. Plus will come. Cofactors also. Remaining all zeros. Then you make this cofactor adjoint. Adjoint, how I am making, you see? Adjoint A is equal to. See, remaining all zero. A11 will come. Okay? A11, A22, A33 are same. That means, see, YZ 0 0 0 A22 here XZ 0 0 0 here XY. Okay, is this adjoint? Definitely this is adjoint. Okay, now A inverse. Why? Because he asked us to find A inverse. A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. That is equal to determinant A. How much it has come? Determinant A, see, this is the determinant A, XYZ. 1 by XYZ into, here write down, YZ 0, 0, 0, XZ 0, 0, 0, XY. Okay, XY, YZ, XZ. Okay. Now, you can say that this is answer, but you send inside XYZ also. Even two more steps are there. A inverse is equal to, if you send XYZ inside, see YZ get cancelled 1 by X. 0, 0. And 0. Here also XZ cancel 1 by Y. 0, 0, 0. Here also XY going to get cancelled. XY by XYZ. 1 by Z. Okay? Even this is also not the answer what they have given in object 2. 1 by X, how can you write? X inverse you can write. 0, 0. 0. 1 by y inverse you can write. 0. 0, 0. 1 by z power minus 1 you can write. Okay? See, for sake is this object 2 or multiple choice, you see this much of procedure is there. Now they have given this answer in your book. Okay? You note down, we will go for 19th question. Okay, let us see the 19th question. This will be the last question for this determinants chapter. Okay, see what they have given. Let matrix A is equal to 1 minus sin theta minus 1, sin theta 1 minus sin theta 1 sin theta 1, where theta is between 0 to 2 pi. That you have to understand this carefully. Theta is between 0 to 2 pi means 0 angle to 360 degree angle, if degrees. Or else radians, 0 radians to 2 pi radians. That means minimum to maximum you have to understand. Then, what will be the determinant value? Whether this determinant is 0 or determinant belongs to 2 to infinity, open. Determinant A belongs to 2 to 4 but open. Determinant belongs to 2 to 4 but closed. Okay? This interval is also very important. Okay? Let us see what will come my answer under. Okay, first let us do the determinant. Okay, we will see what will happen under. See how I am writing. Determinant A, if you see, 1 plus 1 into 1 minus of minus sine square plus sine square. 1 plus sine square theta. 1 sine square, but minus is there. Minus of minus plus sine square theta. Minus sine theta. Okay, minus sine theta into, okay, you see, minus sine theta, minus of minus sine theta, plus sine theta. Understand now? Minus sine theta, minus of minus, plus sine theta. Sine theta have closed center. Again, plus 1, plus, minus, plus, okay? then minus into minus plus sine square theta minus of minus plus 1. You understand now?
How it has come? Okay.
Okay, now what will be the final this thing determinant? See, value we will see afterwards, but what will come? See, here minus sine theta plus sine theta going to get cancelled, then you don't get anything here. Minus sine theta plus sine theta are going to get cancelled. Okay? That means here 0. This term is 0. Then you see 1 into same value will come. 1 plus sine square theta, 1 plus sine square theta. 2 plus 2 sine square theta. Or else we can write 2 plus 2 sine square theta. Okay. Or else we can write this as 2 into 1 plus sine square theta. Is it correct? First you see.
But because 1 plus 1, 2 sine square theta plus sine square theta, 2 sine square theta. Okay. Then 2 plus 2 sine square theta will come. I have taken 2 common. 2 into 1 plus sine square theta. Okay. Now carefully observe how we have to deal this inequality. Why? Because those are inequalities, not equals. Okay. Observe carefully how I am doing this.
First, same you write. Theta is between 0 and 2 pi.
Okay.
Then you see, you want sine square theta in plus 1 into 2. First, step by step you have to go. First, you have to see sine theta. Write down sine theta. Sine theta value how much? Normally, you see sine theta circle diagram I am writing here. Sine theta circle diagram. This is sine theta. Okay. Sine theta circle diagram 0, 1, 0, minus 1.
Okay.
See, from 0 radians to pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi. From 0 to 2 pi, the sine theta value will be minus 1 to 1. Why? Because see, angle is minimum to maximum 0 to 2 pi. But value is minimum to maximum minus 1 to 1. Why? Because see, minus 1 is less than 0. First you have to write minus 1, then finally 1. Okay? The same thing you write here. Minus 1 to 1. Sine theta value. Okay? But what you want? 1 plus sine square theta into 2 1. Step by step you have to go. Then next step you have to take sine square theta. Write down sine square theta value. Sine square theta. Okay? Sine square theta, directly if you square here, here also 1, here also 1 will become 1 to 1. But we should not do like that. Again, you go, have to go back to circle diagram. Okay? This is sine square theta. Here you do this, whatever you want to do in circle diagram. See, sine theta 0 means sine square theta also 0. Sine theta 1 means sine square theta also 1. Sin theta 0 means sin square theta also 0. Sin theta minus 1 means sin square theta plus 1. This is plus 1 here. You understand now? Sin square theta is plus 1. In sin square theta circle diagram, there is no negative numbers. All positive numbers only. Why? Because square you are making. Okay? Wherever negative numbers are there earlier, all are going to become positive. See, here this area will be negative. You know very well, sine theta, all positive, sine positive, here negative, negative. This we know very well for sine. Here all positive. Why? Because you are making square. All these negative are going to become positive. That means there is no negative in sine square theta. Now you tell me limit from 0 radian to 2 pi radian. Minimum is 0, maximum is 1. That value you have to write. Okay? Then 0 to 1 you have to write. Okay? This concept you have to understand carefully. Okay? Next, 1 plus sine square theta. Next step is 1 plus sine square theta. 1 plus sine square theta. Now you add both sides. 1, 1. 1 if you add 1. 1 if you add 2. Okay?
For 0, if you add 1, 1. For 1, if you add 1, 2. It is going to become.
Finally, 2 into 1 plus sine square theta.
Okay.
You multiply with 2. You multiply this with 2. If you multiply with 1, 2, then this is 2. 2 into 2, this is 4.
Okay?
That means value will be 2 to 4. What will be the value? How to write this one? 2 to 4? Is it a closed bracket or open bracket? What will be between these two? See, here equal to is there, both sides. When equal to is there, then this will be your answer. For infinity, there is no equal. Infinity, open. Infinity and all, you can write this one. But for this question, this is not correct. That means what you have to keep? D you have to keep answer.
You understand now? Okay.
Like this, you have to do such questions.
Okay.
Now you see, we have finished this determinants chapter. Next class, we go calculus. Calculus means, again, we are going back to NCERT class 11. Limits and derivatives. Chapter number 13. Afterwards, after that chapter, only one chapter is there in 11. Again, we go back to, come back to class 12. Differentiation, application of differentiation. Integration, application of integration, differential equations. These 5 chapters. Total 6 chapters continuously we will do calculus only. Okay? Thank you very much.